associate applicants at 6 o'clock.
What do you say? Will you go?
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Get some dimes out.
All right, it's a bet.
Yeah, I only took my bite.
Thanks. Oh, hey, wait a minute. I can't do this. I don't get out of here till 6 o'clock.
Listen, you don't want to be a machinist or a druggist all your life.
Oh, what do I tell my parents? They won't be home for this.
Okay, okay. You lose. Give me the dime.
That's it.
These are the entire receipts from last night's performance?
That's it.
I counted more than 30 people in the audience.
Well, some people just put dime in the plate, and some put nothing in at all. And some people just come in to get out of the rain.
But I've descended to this. Put a dime in the plate to see Harrison Marlowe. $8.82. 2 cents? Some monster actually paid 2 cents for a three-act play. That's less than a penny an act. And the world wonders why I drink. Anybody show up?
Yeah, get this. Don Baxter, Don Darwin, and Don Coleman.
Oh, God. No, Don? Where is my darling daughter?
She's here somewhere.
Dad, there's three boys out there.
I know. Any of them look like anything?
Why?
One of them will be your new leading man.
New leading? What happened to Barry Holloway?
I fired him!
How could you do that? He was wonderful. He was my height. Why?
Because he quit. He didn't want it to be paid.
Well, if you don't mind, I'll be my own leading man this time.
May I remind you that this is my theater? I pick the actors.
You may pick them, but I have to perform with them. You don't care what they look like. All you care about is how much money you can squeeze out of them.
All right, all right. Let's take a look at the creatures.
All right, gentlemen. This is Mr. Marlowe.
High School.
That's
his uncle, and he's laughing?
Why?
Because I say so!
You see, he's amused at the false vanity of the others. They're only interested in him for his money. But he's
the devil with him!
Just let me hear you laugh, and go to the speech.
It's just fun to hear you laugh and go to the speech.
Show or Mr. Pike or my daughter.
The show starts at 8:30.
8:30. Should I eat first?
Should you? If you want to.
Work hard, young man. Work very hard.
Oh, I will, sir. And I want to thank you for this opportunity. I want to let you know I'm going to do everything I can to be really excellent.
Fine. Tuxedo for the play.
I don't have one.
You can get a second-hand one for about $10.
$10? I don't have that kind of...
This is Miss Marlowe's dressing room.
Entree.
Go in.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Come in, darling.
But you're...
Come in. I'm sure this isn't the first time you've been in a room where a girl was dressing, Nespa.
Oh, no, ma'am.
I thought not.
I have a kid sister.
That's sweet. So how did
Well, it's just that, well, gee, Miss Marlowe, I don't know if I can do it by Friday night, so I thought I'd tell you now so you can get someone else.
Don. Don, darling, come here. Are you in love?
You mean right now?
Yes.
I think so.
What is Jeff trying to say to that scene? That he loves me. Is that so hard?
I guess not.
Then say it.
Say what?
Say, I love you.
I love you.
Again.
I love you.
I believe you. Now you must express that emotion more deeply, more fully.
Oh, how?
There's only one real way to express love. Everything else is superficial. Shallow.
Oh, yeah!
Poetry. The language of love.
Poems? You mean like right here, quickly?
Yes. I had to say a poem in a play once, and I was in love, so I never forgot it. If I were queen of pleasure, and you were king of pain, we'd hunt down love together, pluck out his flying feather, but teach his feet a measure, and find his mouth the rein. If I were queen of pleasure, and you were king of pain, you do feel it, don't you?
Oh, I do, I do.
But that is not the only way to express love.
Oh, no, of course not.
I know what you're thinking. Something more turbulent, more violent, more exciting.
Yeah.
I cried for madder music and for stronger wine. And when the feast was finished and the lamps expired, then falls thy shadow, Sonata. The night is thine. And I am desolate and sick of an old passion. Yea, hungry for the lips of my desire. I have been faithful to thee, Sonara, in my own fashion.
It's wonderful.
I knew it. I knew you would love poetry as I do. Le mot juste, le mot grand. You are a dear, dear, sensitive boy. You'll be marvelous in the play. You will do it, won't you?
Oh, I will.
I'm You're making me crazy. And you're making yourself crazy, too. Go to sleep.
Hold up somebody.
Who? You want me to call the police?
No, I don't want to get mixed up with the police. Call up Harry.
Harry? Why should I call up Harry?
He's your brother. Why shouldn't you call him?
But why should I call him up in the middle of the night? What can he do?
Harry is a businessman. He has a good lawyer. He'll know what to do.
Emma, make some tea.
You didn't want tea.
No, I'm not.
So why don't you call Harry?
Emma, please. At 3 o'clock, I don't call up my brother for advice about my son.
But I'm worried. I don't know what to think. What should we do?
All right. It's all right. You'll see. It's all right.
Hello? What are you doing up so late?
Did you hear that, Morris? What are we doing up so late? What are we doing up so late? Oh, it was too hard to sleep, so we got up to play a game of dominoes.
Mama,
Turkish, I would understand.
No kidding. Ooh.
Say, Mark, won't they miss you upstairs?
Nah. But what happened after you got to progress?
Well, we rehearsed for a little while, and then we started to get, you know, more comfortable.
You mean undress?
Sort of.
What do you mean? Who's a lot what? I mean, did you help you take anything off?
No, we called it a get off the streets.
Well, you did call earlier. What time you call? Ah, well, I
save you so much.
I can give this boy a holster.
Oh, no!
Thanks, you're a great girl, really. I'll pay you back.
shoes with the tuxedo, the mustache with the grease and all that. Not in the shop. Here we don't need no Greta Garbo.
I know, Mr. Foreman. What happened again?
I broke the press show for your father.
What?
The press show for your father's birthday.
Oh. Thanks, Mr. Foreman.
Look, that's a $4 press show. I'll pay you that in next week's pay. Thanks, Mr. Foreman.
A next guy. Now let's try your entrance.
And remember,
I'm nauseous. Mr. Marlowe, I know I wasn't very good. You know it. I know it. Now it's our job to keep that dirty little secret.
Thank you.
no.
Why not?
I don't want the bottle, especially from Harry. But I needed a hernia operation. Did I go running to him? No, I managed.
You managed? You still need a hernia operation.
I got it across.
Congratulations.
So what's such an emergency you want to go running to Harry?
Goodbye.
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 But that'd be too long.
chap.
David, I don't poison in this business, this place.
errand.
Shut up, Barb.
Just quiet. Shut up.
Hey, what do you think you're hiding me for? If you're sort of errand, what do you think you got on me for?
What kind of reason do they have?
Well, no matter.
Be quiet, please.
Do? know I can't wear this.
Sorry, David, I only...
Go by Mr. Marlowe. Just ask everybody if he's Mr. Marlowe. Oh, Mr. Marlowe. It's me. I thought you said you couldn't come.
Very nice.
What do you know about her?
couple of bits of stories, throw the crap around. Same as acting, right? Don't get any stains on this, will you?
What's the matter, Bob? Hasn't your
thank you.
to prove my point.
That's very interesting, Jeff.
I'm sorry, Angela.
I mean, Harriet. While you have thought of me as a mere playboy these past few years, I have been on a secret mission for my uncle. He's lying.
Go on, Jeff.
Thank you, my dear.
Talk about it.